Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and today we're here in Computex 2025, and with us we have Craig. Hey, Craig, how's it going?
Hey, Alex, thanks for having me, man.
Yes, I see we have some amazing laptops here, but I think you're also gonna tell us there's like an assistant in there.
Oh, we have some great news that we're talking about here at Computex, and one of those is the brand new introduction that we're talking about with AI Assistant Builder, which is now up on GitHub and free and available for anyone to use today.
That's pretty cool. So what type of, different assistants do we have?
Great. So let me give you the experience. So when you go to the website for what we have for Assistant Builder, you can go up there and it immediately asks you what kind of chatbot that you're looking to build. So is it financial? Is it a personal assistant? Is it medical? So all of those I can go ahead and derive to an individual use case, and we'll also take a look at my system to be able to see what kind of models that I'll be able to use for that chatbot interface. Then based on those two inputs, it'll go ahead and grab the model that's recommended for your system as well as usage, download those all, package it up into a nice EXE that downloads right onto your desktop, and now that is your personal chatbot that only runs local directly on your AI PC. So truly an amazing piece of software that you can make immediately. And again, did I tell you the price? It's free.
Wow, absolutely. That's amazing. So I guess you have a couple examples you can show us?
Yeah, let's go ahead and see what this thing can do. So we all know what chatbots can do currently, and the standard interface that we have for AI Assistant Builder also includes RAG, or Retrieval Augmented Generation, so all of your documents you can go ahead and interact with. But now there's some new pieces of technology that we're rolling up here with the release of AI Assistant Builder, and one of those is MCP, which is a interesting new way for agents to go ahead and work, with 2025 being the year of agentic AI. With MCP, which is Model Context Protocol, it's actually a new way, kind of like a way for AI to be able to talk to other API type of a backend, mm-hmm. but in a communication way that uses inference and AI speak so that all of that data can be, you basically have a two-way conversation that's much more intelligent. So let me give you a quick example here. So right here, I'm gonna go ahead and actually, we're going to call out some agents that we currently have involved in the current model. So what I've done with that monster prompt that we've just put in here, I've asked it to do a couple of things all at once. The mm-hmm. first of all, I wanted to go ahead and we have an upcoming Seattle trip. So I wanted to grab everyone from my team, be able to organize all of our travel details, put them together, send them out to my team so that we can all book and travel together. So I've gone ahead and tasked this, and usually we have all of our data here local, but now with these agents, I've actually tasked it to say, find me that flight info for these individual dates and come back with the best, categories within price. Same thing with hotels. Then draft an email for me. So it's gone, one agent has gone to check the flights, one agent has gone to check the hotel, and then another piece of code says, no problem, let me package this up in a nice summary email and then send it to a webmail backend, like a Gmail or one of those pieces. This is all done with this new protocol, and it makes it easy for inference to be passed from one location to the next and be able to retrieve data. In addition to running that LLM locally here, now we can reach out a little bit farther and get answers that we don't have contained here as well. Pretty cool stuff.
But yeah, that's pretty impressive.
We're also taking a look at how we can work with the data that we're ingesting. So it's not just your text documents or your PDFs that we're looking at now. We're actually really looking to glean a lot of data out of those pieces. So let's take a look at this. And for our assistant builder that we have here, we've actually built into it, which you can see here is called a resume match. And mm-hmm. so this is something where we are not only chatting with the documents, but we're actually analyzing them based on a prompt that I'm gonna deliver. So for this resume match, so say this is actually an HR model. And so if I was looking for a position that I wanted to hire for, I'm gonna go ahead and take a look at all the resumes that have been sent for this particular job. And then I'm gonna throw the job description directly in the prompt. Now, what it's going to do is I'm looking for a mechanical learning engineer. It's going to go ahead and go through all of those individual resumes and summarize them and then match them to the requirements of that job requirement. Now it's coming back and scoring those resumes based on their fit and match. And in which case, I'm fetching the details of the top candidates who are matching here and getting a summary of their resume pieces. So it really is a huge help, especially for an HR department sifting through thousands of resumes, but this also interjects with, I can go ahead and intervene with human help as well. So I'm not necessarily gonna pick that 90 plus score, but it will guide me into a way to really be able to bring quality candidates. And again, this is just another piece of data that I'm analyzing. As a CEO for my company, I can take an Excel sheet and be able to take all my margins and be able to run them out in a summary. So not just summarizing the entire document, but I can pick and choose how that data is actually parsed out of these pieces. So two really amazing pieces that we're bringing to Assistant Builder. And again, now it's public and it's free for everyone to use. So I would say great advice is go out there and try it for yourselves.
That's going to be awesome. And you also, we were talking earlier, you said like you can change the models that you wanted to and plug in all the different stuff.
That's exactly. And it's with our AI PCs, especially from this on Intel Core Ultra, we have compatibility across all these models. So whether you're running Gwen, Llama, Phi, any of those individual models, hundreds that we have for compatibility, you can pick and choose about what fits great.
That's awesome. Craig, thank you very much.
Always a pleasure.
Appreciate it.
Thank you, Alex.